This is Estate of Cloud, where this week acquisitions in the cloud computing space, your server is dedicated for you, sir, and you alone, and migration market is growing faster than expected. With the recent acquisition news, last week was Microsoft acquisition of GitHub the headliner, which is dominating the news headlines. All kinds of expressions have been expressed, very from "I will take my code offline" till also that Microsoft can help me grow my code. For sure, this acquisition is being proved that Microsoft is serious about their approach to gain market share at the open source terrain. And if this acquisition will be a surplus for Microsoft or just a snack, we will see in the near future. For sure, we can see a bundling of all acquisitions, where you can Minecrafting through your LinkedIn, communicating with them via Skype, and show your code to one of your potential customers. Speaking of transformations, for those among us who followed my post on LinkedIn, have read the recent acquisition of Entor SRL by Iradios. Iradios is a private equity funded company recently built up, which has a strong focus on expanding their activities in Italy. And by the recent acquisition of Entor, its portfolio has now the ability to offer a broad segment of services. Not only 14 data centers, but also OpenStack as one of the driving platforms behind their cloud strategy. OpenStack itself was, by the way, also in the news this week. The foundation updated the publication about migration of the workloads using OpenStack, both on KVM or Xen Hypervisor. And if you are interested to learn more about it, go check them out on the website on openstack.org. And if you really have a burning question about how to migrate, follow us via this video. In the next episode, I will discuss more about this migration elements and how to do it with some easy steps. Another nice news from Google this week. Google announced that they finally have opened their cloud compute platform and offered now the customers a dedicated server. In this line, they are following the competitors who already did it on the earlier stage, but now Google also have the option to do it. And as a takeaway, of course, like every week, we have some events you could learn more about stuff if you attend them. So tomorrow, it's an exciting day for those who are working in the data center market. June 12 has been announced as the day of the data center by the Dutch Data Center Association. And all across the Netherlands, they have open doors for those who would like to learn more about the data center. So check out their link on the website. Of course, next week is finally there, TNO's Ultra Fast Broadband Summit in The Hague. The largest event about broadband and very relevant for those who are relying on connectivity. A week later, one summit event organized in Frankfurt. And in both events, I will be present myself as well as the company. So if you are in the neighborhood and would like to learn more about it, feel free to stop by one of those. This is it for this week. I hope you like it. If you like it, share it among your peers. If you don't like it, share it among your peers and then let them laugh. And if you have any contributions or elements you would like to see in the show, feel free to contact me. Cheers!